Hello, I'm sigsolo. Welcome to my channel. Today is Tiny Tuesday tryout number 47, and I have something very ugly for you. I have the Windsor Pro, the above the tire Windsor Pro ugly stuff. And why do I call it ugly? Well, when you order from the side, they have this, the normal one. They have the scratch and dent section, and then they have the ugly stuff section. And when you order from the ugly stuff section, it states that it's stuff too ugly to be or scratched up, to be sold as scratch and dent. It might have blemishes, it might have tool marks, polish marks and stuff like that. So I ordered this and I paid, it was $50. And then I applied the IMCDB code and I got 10% off, so it was $45. And then I waited for it to arrive. It arrived, took 4 weeks. It arrived here and it got here in a little carton box, not their normal box. In the carton box was this with some paper around it, and I thought, well, it's $45. And it states that the razor is perfectly good working. And then I opened it, and this was in it. And it's stunning. I don't see any marks. I don't see anything. Well, I see my thumbs now, but the only thing I can see that there is a slight difference between the SB and the 90. But that's only if I look very, very carefully in a very special light and stuff like that, because no tooling marks, no dents, no nicks, no nothing. This is stunning. So I wrote them a mail, said, well, I expected this to be scratched and dented or more than that, misalignments or, well, I don't know what, but it looks perfect. And they said they were very happy that I was very happy, but it didn't pass their control. So if this is their ugly stuff standard, just imagine, I don't see any faults on it. It's flawless. And I only paid $45 for this. At the moment of this recording, I see that it's still available, this razor, in their ugly stuff section. And I have no idea, I cannot promise you that it will be looking this good. But I asked them if I got a special treatment, that they sent me a real one just because they knew maybe my name or something. They didn't. This didn't pass their inspection, so it's awesome. It's the Kronos 3.5 inch handle, and I actually forgot to weigh this, so I will put the weight down here if I remember to weigh, because I forgot. But I would say it's a good 105 grams. That's what it feels like. Solid stainless steel 3.16, I think, I don't remember, but it's stainless steel. It has a rounded, it's rounded down here, so you cannot put it up. So you need to remember that. But this is, I don't see anything wrong with it, and I'm babbling on, I'm sorry. Today's soap is this, the 345 Yacht Club. And that's another story, because, let me just wet my face as I tell this. In the beginning of December, I made an order of 345 soaps for two soaps. Come one more, it was shipped in the beginning of December by John, and it didn't arrive. Then at the end of February, I got a mail from the postal service stating that this soap was most likely lost because they hadn't had an update on it for a month. So I contacted John and said they say that it's most likely gone because there hasn't been an update on it for a month, for more than a month. And he said, no problem, I'll refund you, I'm sorry, and all that. And then another month passed and I got this parcel with these, with the two soaps in it. This looks like I overordered it, I'm sorry. Let me just apply a little more. And I immediately wrote John and said, sorry, John, the soaps that you refunded me a month ago arrived today. Would you like me? Well, I think I wrote, let me transfer the money to you that you refunded me. And he said, no. Use it. Be happy with it. I'm just glad that you got your soap in the end and that you were satisfied. So he wouldn't have my money. So this was actually, this soap was actually a gift. Just like you might say, the very good price on the above the tie razor was kind of a gift. So was this soap. Started off as a normal purchase and it ended up as a gift from John. So John, if you're watching, thank you very much. And above the tie, if you're watching, thank you for having such high quality standards. I don't know why it was being called ugly stuff, but to me it's far better looking than a lot of premium stuff I've gotten. I won't mention any names, but that's a standard to live up to for the others. So the brush for today is the Alpha Shaving Albert with the G4 48mm knot in it. In the razor I have the Persona, the Lab Blue, the American one, and that's it. So let's get this party started. This razor is called regular to aggressive, I think they call it. Is it heavy? It's a 6 out of 9 on above the tires aggression scale. It's the SB90 plate, so it's a 0.90 blade gap. I feel the blade. Not a lot, but I feel it. I would say just enough for me to know where I'm going. I like that in a razor. So, after my 7-day challenge, I've been shaving either every day or every other day. And one of the clear advantages I've gotten is up here in the upper lip. Only having one or 2 days of stubble on there makes shaving far easier. Much more enjoyable. And gives skin that's far less irritated. To me, this doesn't feel like a razor in the very aggressive end of the scale, 6 or 7 out of 9. But that's how it is. I like this a lot. My ugly razor. I'm sorry I'm smiling because it's perfect. It really is. Man. The G4 knot here in this brush is one of my preferred, apart from the, what do you call it, cashmere knot that I really, really like. This with a very little backbone It's very nice too, the G4. And this is the 28mm G4. You don't see that many of the 28mm G4 knots, I think. Usually they're 24, 26. So this is a little bigger. I don't mind. Has this wonderful, you know, waist here for me to hold. You know, I'm not a face scrubber. So. I like the waisty, easy to hold for my huge hands thingy. So. I will be going straight for the against the grain on the neck. That's one I learned from the 7 days. So. Go a little slower down here, but go straight to the against. Against the grain. I forgot to talk about the scent of the soap. The Yacht Club soap is a dupe. This is the wrong way, I'm sorry. Is a dupe of the Paco Rabanne Million. And I get that. It's a solid 6, almost 7. When you lather it up, or when I lathered it up to my nose, from the puck, it's a little stronger. It's a 7.5, I would say. It's not as strong when I lather it up, but you know, we can manage, right? So let me just go this way. Man, this is a fantastic razor. Go check out my site. Only thing I can see different from the full price one is the box. This arrived in a little cardboard box. Wrapped in a wrapping paper. So, that's just how it is. Okay, so, fantastic feeling, no irritation that I can feel anywhere. Any weepers? I don't think so. Well, very, very little down there, but you know, it doesn't count. It doesn't weep, it's just a reddish or breathing or whatever. This is a fantastic shaver. The hc&c Bossman's accessory, the preferred shaving towel in this den. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Okay, the aftershave is the Arko Gold Power, and that's also a dupe of the Paco Rabanne Million. Yeah, and this contains alcohol, and this is far stronger in the scent. And I only get a little burn right here. Only a little, nothing on the upper lip. And that's one of the advantages from doing the straight to against the grain on the second pass. I think that I saved some irritation up here. My upper lip haven't felt this great for more than a year. Aftershave balm is also Arko, but this one is called the Blue. Oh no, it's called Cool. Has a cologne vibe to it. I don't have the gold, if it exists, the gold power. But this has, this is more like the Acqua di Gio, I would say. From, yeah, Gio. So, is it called Gio? Yeah, I think it is. Doesn't matter. But this was a great shave. So, don't be offended by the ugly in the title. That's what they called it on the side, the ugly stuff section. It's not, it's perfect. It's, you know, there's nothing wrong with the one I received, so perfect razor. And that's it. Like, subscribe, hit the bell, and share. And you know why we do this? We do this because we are not obsessed. We are dedicated. Sig Solo, signing out.